Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Jesus Christ. Right, welcome along, guys. Welcome to Salty Sebring for a VRS GT sprint race. We're in the Ferrari. It's 2.2k strength of field. There's a lot of talking points. The little bit at the beginning isn't even the half of it. So there's a report coming from me on this one. I'm not normally one for reports in iRacing, but the way this guy behaved here, there's just no need for it. Don't want to see that sort of thing in iRacing. Hopefully you guys will agree that I've not done anything to warrant this sort of thing. But yeah, really interesting race from beginning to end. So hopefully you'll stick with me. If you like the video, give us a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it. Right, let's get into it.
You ready to roll here, man? That's fun. All right, my man, pace cars off.
Be ready.
Ready, green, 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 green. Right side. Still there. Still there. Clear. On your right.
You guys are awful.
Still
with
there.
This game.
Go there. Clear.
Come on, man.
On the left side.
Before that was
still there.
Stupid.
Clear.
Seriously, how are you guys so bad at this?
On your left. Still there. Still there. Clear.
A bit sketchy coming out. The BM's gone behind, so pressure's off there. At least from him. Next one will slot into the spot for now. I tried to do one of these yesterday and it was this next right turn that got me on the cold tyres. Just over rotated, ended up in that wall on my right.
He's moving, He's up, one off course. Keep coming.
Looks like a slowdown. Somebody launched it then. Got it wrong, took the Ferrari. I think it was the Lambo that lost out on the final corner. Sunset, is it? I think it was that guy who launched it. So I think we're still 15th. Lost and gained.
Thank you.
Not sure if we always get that yellow flag thrown there, but it seemed like there was any issue. So he's in for whatever reason.
2:01.63.
Will fuel save a little bit behind Chris. He doesn't look too comfortable, to be honest. So we're one in the red.
Pass me on the right, mate. Go on the right.
Just have a look at where everyone is. I'm not lining Chris up for a dive bomb or anything. So this Lambo's right back with us now. He's in draft of me. I'm definitely a little bit better on the brakes than Chris.
He's moving.
It's not what you want to hear when you're coming around there blind. All right, though. I'm thinking about an undercut here then. I'm pitting A10, so do you want to go by?
On your right.
clear. On your left. Corner clear.
Yeah, well, that was poor, but we're safe, so we'll see what we can do.
Go, 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 go.
Well, I'm bothered about he's not getting wrecked there. Clear bit of track, fuel to the end, hopefully. Got to diesel at my tyres, so I had to do it on the way in, so I was a little bit cautious. Went in slow, stopped it slow. It was just a rubbish pit stop, to be honest. But I think I was going to be losing time by staying there, so I think it made sense. We'll see. The only reason I'm not sure about the fuel is because I was fuel saving behind Chris, was it? And sometimes when I've done that in the past, race labs has kind of got it wrong. I put in an extra 2 litres, probably too much, but that also slowed the stop down. But yeah, the Audi was going to be coming through. I was definitely losing time to Chris. So, hopefully it'll pay off. If I can get back in the green, like I said, I'll be happy. So far, so good on the incidents. Just 1x. Lost a bit of heat out of the fronts, can't seem to get them working. Right, these guys are both for position. Sorry, they're not. They haven't pitted. It's the two behind me that have. One's a lap down. So I've got some new settings for True Drive off Mr. Dan Suzuki. I'm really liking them. Really liking them. It's a little more damping going on. There's a few more filters and stuff like that than what I've been running. But it definitely feels more realistic.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Your way up there nice and smooth, bud.
which is always the goal. As close to the real thing as we can. So we'll see what sort of times we're doing, try and get back into a little rhythm. 2:01.5 last time round. Doing a little wide coming in there. Not sure if I should be down a second for that or just sort of coast through in third. Not sure I'd get the rotation that I would need if I kept it in third. Might be worth looking at next time round. Is he coming in? Good stuff. So we're going to have to get past him. 2 ahead of me, I think, and he was struggling a little bit. Or 2 ahead before the Lambo got past me anyway. He seemed to be making a few mistakes. But I haven't got past him with a pit stop, so the undercut's not as strong as I would have hoped. At least mine wasn't, but I did make a very slow pit stop, so I suppose I can't expect to jump him. He's come in from 11th though, Luis, which was my position I think before I came in, so don't think we've lost any time during the pit stop, which is good. I was in positive I rating before I came in, so there's no need to push here. At least not yet. Ooh, he's turning. He's trying to get it turned in there. He looked like he had a lot of steering input on there. I thought he was turning the car around, to be honest. Thank you. didn't want to dive bomb up the inside there.
Hey, my name is Francis, you okay? You're going down.
He's moving. Got one to dirt, coming back on. Stay right. Car is a lap down ahead of us.
So we had to check up a little bit there to avoid that guy. I don't know if he was a back marker or what. I think he was. Got that wrong.
Two, minute 1.82.
So we're not dropping Luis. So it'll stay with me. Catching some of these guys, the BMW mid-bin it, seemed a little bit twitchy. Not this one specifically, just in general.
In the middle of the track, into the middle of the track, slow car off to the right. Stay on your toes.
Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Jesus Christ. Yeah, don't apologize. Don't worry about it.
2:03.071. So you're right there with them, bud. Doing a great job. You got it. Go get him, man. Doing a great job.
Right, just need to settle down a bit. Could have been a lot worse. So I don't even know if it was a position that we gained. It'd be nice if it was. What an absolute whopper, eh? So annoyingly, we've got back up to Luis. We'll just see what happens. Settle myself a little bit here. We're in a good spot. P10. 25 in the green. 3 incidents, so positives all around here. I suppose gathering yourself after something like that is one of the disciplines. One that I'm yet to master. Just little mistakes here and there might cost me if I'm not careful. Not another one. Seriously, stay still.
just hold your brakes. I mean, if you've gone into the wall, tow, you're not going to get it back. Again, could have been worse. No yellow flag there, but it's telling me there's a car. Ah, oh, here we go. Back marker. Thanks, mate. In the grass there. You can say, well, that little mistake cost him all the way through that sequence of corners. Two or three laps left. Shouldn't be moving over like that once he's picked his line in the braking zone. See how we move back across. Shouldn't be doing that.
Left side. Clear. Good job.
So he's giving me a little flash there because I was sort of semi making a move, and then he didn't defend it, left the door open.
On your right. Clear, clear.
What are you flashing at, Louise? Just leave the door open, mate. I'm going to go for it. There's no contact. Just get over it, mate. Flashing, mate, you turned into me on that one.
2:02.693. Keep it going. Go one more. One more.
It wasn't me, I'm just killing you, okay?
Shut up.
Easy.
I'll get them lights looked at, Lewis. Happy with that?
Let's see if it's a sunset or I just have to look for a second at the start who punted me back the record too, by the way.
Well done, my friend.
Jesus,
well
what's
done.
That
wow. Wow, Luis. Well done, mate. That's a report. That's a report, isn't it? Genius. Right, there we go. Top 10 finish, P8. I'm really pleased with that. I think I drove pretty well, avoided what I needed to avoid when I needed to avoid it. So I'm pleased with that. But yeah, what's all that about? What's all that about? So he left the door open. I don't know the name of these corners, apologies. But he left the door open going into the right-hander. There may have been a little bit of net code, but I kind of semi went for the move to kind of spook him a little bit. He left the door open for me. As I got close to him, I thought he just steered away from me. There may have been a little bit of net code. But then just he continued to flash his lights at me when he was behind me. I had a little moan on the radio. We went into sunset. And obviously you just hard right. So I'm fighting the contours of the track and everything else and trying to keep the car balanced and everything. I'm just, you know, constantly turning right and he's on a different line clearly. And he's just turned into me there, which was again nothing to do with me. And then continues to flash his lights. And then again I think he has another little moan. And then yeah, at the end of the race just plows straight into me to let me know how tough he is, I guess. I don't know what the thought process is there, but it's incredible to do that. Especially, I mean, I've got a direct drive wheel. Some of you guys have this equipment as well, and it can injure you. This stuff can really hurt you. So there's absolutely no need for that sort of behaviour. I could understand him being a little bit upset about losing the position, but close the door, defend. You know, you're ahead of me. Defend your position. I'm not going to run in the back of you. Certainly not, you know, deliberately. I'm not going to run you off the track. Mistakes will happen, and there will be a little bit of contact, but no one got damage out of that first little bit. There's absolutely no reason for him to be upset there, but yeah, it's just the way it goes. So no apology or nothing from him, not in the race, not afterwards while we were looking at the replays or whatever, and not after. We've settled for a bit now. It's been a couple of hours. He's had time to reflect on it and nothing. So, yeah, that report's going in from me. Just no need for it. Absolutely no need for it. But I'm taking the positives out of this. Let me have a look. We are 39 in the green, I rating, and we've made 0.6 up on our safety rating as well. So everything's moving in the right direction. But apart from that, I felt consistent. I felt pretty quick. And I felt comfortable in that race, which, on the new rig, in the new gear, with the new pedals and everything, I'm really impressed with everything here. So, yeah, big thanks to Pro Sim Rig and Race Anywhere for all this stuff. And I've gone a bit logo crazy, as you can see, but, you know, race car stuff in it. So, yeah. Right, if you like the video, guys, give us a thumbs up. If you're not subscribing, click the subscribe button over there. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you on the next one. Cheers, guys.